Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. He is really, really, he's way gooder than you think he is. Matter of fact, he's not as good as you think. He's way better. I know gooder isn't proper English, but the English language cannot contain God. He's gooder than the English language. And sometimes we just say God is good, and that's just so trite. I mean, you know, you can say like happy birthday or, you know, happy holidays. I don't like that. I like to say Merry Christmas. I always say that. When they say happy holidays, I say Merry Christmas to you. I said, I'm one of those Merry Christmas people. I said, we're celebrating Jesus. And they said, oh, they go, I'd like to do that too, but they won't let me. I go, well, I'll let you. Go ahead. I won't tell on you. Let her rip. That's fine. And we want to be a people that cultivate a culture of honor. And part of a culture of honor is being thankful. It's being thankful for what God does in people's lives. I was so blessed. I'd never met Jessica Brown before, and she told how the Lord delivered her and set her free, and how she's coming on Monday nights, and how she got saved here, and how people are helping her. And I watched. I said, I want you, this is a new member of our church family. I want you to surround her. I want you to take her out for coffee. I want you to buy her. I want you to bless her. And you know, but before she got out of her chair, there was four or five people standing around her. You listened. That's good. And I want thanksgiving. I don't want just, and I want some, can Psalm 107 stuff you this morning? Can we stuff you with goodness stuffings? You've been stuffed. I want to just stuff you with thanksgiving. I want you to be a stuffed Thanksgiving spirit-filled Christian turkey. Well, eagle. Eagle. We'll stuff eagles. That's better than turkeys. It's hard to soar like an eagle, they say, when they work with a bunch of turkeys. So we're going to work with eagles instead. Psalm 107, verse 1. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. For his mercy endures forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Say so. I am redeemed. That's good. You got it. We're going to stuff you. Whom he has redeemed from the hand of the enemy and gathered out of the lands from the east and from the west and from the north and the south. They wandered in the wilderness in a desolate way. They found no city to dwell in. Hungry and thirsty, their soul fainted in them. Then they cried out to the Lord in their trouble, and he delivered them out of their distresses, and he led them forth by the right way, that they might go to a city for a dwelling place. Oh, that men would give thanks to the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. See, we can give thanks to God because he saved us from our enemies, and he's gathered us out of our wanderings. We all wandered, didn't we? We all, like sheep, went our own way. We all thought we could do it ourselves, let's be honest. And we all wandered away, and we all came to the end of our ropes, to the end of ourselves, and one day we cried out to the Lord, and when we cried out to the Lord, what happened? He saved us. You're going to find in Psalm 107, sometimes he allows people to go quickly to themselves so that they get so frustrated with their own selves that they turn to him and cry out to him. He's so good, he does that as a good father. Remember what Dr. Thomas said? Hear me, hide me, and help me. And that's what we started to cry. We either said, God, help me, or hide me, or hear me. Some of us said all three. I learned help was one of the most spiritual prayers you can pray. Somebody help the boy. That's my constant prayer. Somebody help the boy. Because I heard a story from Dr. Dobson once where his son Ryan got lost and they couldn't find him, and he wandered down this alley and ended up on one of those trucks where they had produce, and they were lifting him up, and it lifted him up, and he was looking in all the produce, and they must have put it down, didn't know he was there, and it started going down, and he was afraid he was going to fall, so he stuck his arms over the edge of the big tailgate, and he was suspended in midair with his legs kicking, and they found him, and he was wiggling like this, and he was going, somebody help the boy, somebody help the boy. So every once in a while I'd say, Lord, somebody help the boy. When I feel like I'm dangling like that. You know what? He'll help you when you cry out to him. Help's a good prayer. And you know, he saves us from our enemies. He says because we should be telling people about our redemption. We should be saying so that we've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. We should be thanking God and giving testimony to people about what God has done in our life. All the stories today, there wasn't one story told in the first service that wouldn't have helped someone realize that God's a good God. Healings of lymphoma, of non-cancer, cancerous lymphoma, of heart problems they said would never be healed, of deliverance from sexual abuse, on and on and on. They're just all testimonies, and the redeemed of the Lord are going to say so this morning. Sherry's going to be sharing in just a moment. And he gathered us from the east, the west, the north. He gathered us out of all kinds of background situations. It didn't matter. We all cried out to the Lord, and he saved us, didn't he? And he saved us from our wanderings, from being hungry and thirsty. And a lot of us tried to fill our appetites with all kinds of things. But I want you to be stuffed with Thanksgiving today. I want Thanksgiving stuffings to be coming out of you. So Sherry's going to be the first testimony. That's point number one. We got four more. And she's going to tell you about how God saves someone and how God delivers someone. You're going to hear how good God is. This is Thanksgiving Sunday, so get ready to give thanks. She's armed and dangerous, so get ready.
My prodigal son came home.
Yes. Woo!
Monday night, he was in his garage at his house. He lives with a couple guys and listening to a gospel rap song. And he said, Mom, it really was speaking to me. And he said, I heard God say, go to your room. I went to my room, he said, and he said, I had an encounter with God for 3 hours.
Woo!
My son is Brennan Millay, and he's now on fire for Jesus again.
Yeah.
And he literally said, Mom, I see Jesus. I keep seeing Jesus. I have seen him this week. He's just got this big old grin on his face.
Oh, give thanks to the Lord. Oh, give thanks to the Lord for his goodness and his mercy to the children of men. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Sherry, I want you to pray for prodigal sons and prodigal daughters right now. I want you to make a declaration. She gave me an orange card to pray for her son and some of her people. Come here, Sherry, you're going to pray right here in the front. And there's also a couple in Indonesia. I put them on that card because I've been praying for them. It's stuck in the middle of my old Bible. I had my sixth Bible failed on me. It ripped apart. I've heard if your Bible's falling apart, you're probably not. So I've started on my seventh Bible. I bought it this morning in the bookstore, one of the Spirit-filled Bibles, because mine's ripping apart. I've had her son's name, another person's name on. I've been praying for them. And there was a couple that were told in Indonesia, I said, you will never have children. And he said, my greatest desire is to be a father. And I just found out last week from Indonesia that she's now 21 weeks pregnant. But the doctor said it's impossible for her to get pregnant. She's pregnant. They're on the same card. So I got two answers on the same card. You go ahead and pray for people right now.
Oh, dear God Almighty,
yes.
I thank you that your promises are yes and amen. I thank you, God,
yes.
that
stand
when you
right
say
now.
It,
thank
it's
you,
done.
Lord.
We need to
save
stand
them,
on your
Lord.
Word.
Yes.
We need to stand
yes.
on your word and proclaim.
Thank you, Lord.
We need to ask
Bring
it.
Them home.
We need to receive it.
Bring
and
them
we
home.
Declare this day that the prodigal
yes.
sons,
yes.
the prodigal daughters,
from the north,
are coming back to you this day
to
lift up the name of Jesus. Oh, God Almighty, pour into them power and might and visit them this day.
Yes.
I give them to you, every single one of
them.
They're yours, and Satan, we're stomping on you. We're stomping on you in the blood of Jesus. You have no power.
Yes.
At the name of Jesus, you are God.
Yes.
And we're taking
Bring
the authority
home.
That is ours in
Bring
our
Bring them home.
Bring them home. Bring them home.
Yes.
Glory to you, O God Almighty. We give you praise, and it is in the praise.
Yes.
It is in the praise,
yes.
people. Please, it's
yes.
in the praise and the worship.
Yes.
And the battle is won up
yes.
here. Oh, glory
Thank
to you,
you,
dear God Almighty. We
Thank
love you.
You.
Amen.
And we declare they'll be home for Christmas. We declare they'll be home for Christmas. Bring them back, Father. Bring back the prodigals and the daughters and the sons. Yes. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. We are redeemed, Lord. We are thankful. You are all in all. Hallelujah. Point number two. See, point number one wasn't too bad. It's going to go quick. Point number two. Oh, that men would give thanks to the Lord for his goodness. You can go ahead and give thanks, right? Well, the word's going on. And for his wonderful works to the children of men, for he satisfies the longing soul and fills the hungry soul with goodness. You get stuffed with his goodness, too, along with Thanksgiving. Those who sat in darkness and in the shadow of death, bound in affliction and irons, because they rebelled against the words of God and despised the counsel of the Most High. Therefore he brought down their heart with labor. They fell down and there was none to help. Then they cried out to the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them out of their distresses. He brought them out of darkness and the shadow of death and broke their chains in pieces. Oh, that men would give thanks to the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. You can thank God because he fills us with goodness and he delivers us. He sets us free. It's amazing what he does. They were rebels who sat in darkness in the shadow of death, just like we were, bound in affliction and irons. Why? Because we rebelled against the words that God spoke, and we didn't take his counsel. But guess what? He laid more labor on us. He loved us so much, he laid labor on us so we'd get to the end of ourselves quicker. That we would cry out to the Lord. And when we cried out, it says that he put labor on them, speaking of Israel. This is really the history of all people that have been redeemed. It's not just about Israel, though in this context it is. It's about how he brought them back, but it's really the history of all the people of all the ages that have wandered through the wilderness and the deserts, have tried everything in their own help, and there was none to help, and they cried to the Lord, and then he saved them. If you cry out to the Lord this morning, and you have a need for deliverance, he'll break the chains. He'll snap the chains off you. He'll deliver you. He'll set you free. Point number two is over. Is there someone that's been delivered that wants to give a testimony one at a time? Only one at a time. I'm going to keep ordering this service. Come on, you come up and share about how you got delivered. And I've got good news. It was so awesome when Jessica Brown shared how she got delivered. Now she's been coming here and what's been happening in her life. Now she'd given herself over to all kinds of things, but now she's been saved and she's walking with God. Tell everybody who you are and how you got delivered. That's awesome.
Praise God.
Amen.
I'm Patrick Biamugisha. I come from Uganda. I've been to this church 1 year now.
Yes.
If you have seen me something back about 6 weeks ago, I had a skin infirmity.
Yes.
He actually prayed for me one of the services where they call us up front. The skin was even, I think, it had challenged the doctors. I was seeing the best doctor in Washington, a skin specialist. He could not find a solution. He asked me, what's the problem? I can't find any problem. I thought there were allergies. They did all the tests of allergies, and there was nothing like that. But I'm here to give thanks to the Lord.
Yes.
We believe and we give thanks to the living God because he never forsakes us. Yes. He never forsook me because yes. I was there all the time asking for his faithful yes. love, and he did deliver me. As you see me here, I give thanks because I knew where I was coming from.
Hallelujah.
Thanks be to God.
When I prayed for Patrick, I didn't recognize him when he first walked up. When I prayed for him, it was like he had cirrhosis all over his skin. There's nothing on your skin at all. Woo! God is good! It's a good thing to give thanks to the Lord. It's a good thing to give thanks to the Lord for his goodness and his wonderful works to Patrick. You might want Patrick to pray for if you have skin problems, because once you've received, you can give it away. That's the good news, and it keeps growing. Like that little story about lies, you know, when you tell a little lie and it kind of grows out of the closet. You know what? It's even better with the truth when you tell the truth. It scatters all over. God bless you, Patrick. I didn't even know that till right now. That's awesome. You look like a new man. Isn't that awesome? Where are you? Oh, boy. Point number three. Give thanks to the Lord for his mercy and his healing. Whoa. It gets better. Oh, that men would give thanks to the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. For he has broken the gates of bronze and cut the bars of iron in two. Fools, because of their transgression and because of their iniquities, were afflicted. Their soul abhorred all manner of food, and they drew near to the gates of death. Then they cried out to the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them out of their distresses. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destructions. Oh, that men would give thanks to the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. He's merciful to the fools. He's the king of fools. That's why he's my king. He's chosen the foolish things of the world to confound the wisdom of men. Men are fooled by the wisdom of men. But I'll tell you, the wisdom of God, he chooses the foolish things and confounds the wisdom of the nobles and the wise. The word noble is Eugene's. It means good genes. But I tell you, we got better genes when we came to Jesus. And I'm not talking about Levi's. I'm talking about the genes that come through the lineage of being part of the root of Jesse, being part of the seed of Abraham, having the blood of Jesus and that DNA put in you when you're born again by the Holy Spirit. And you know what? Because of their transgression, their iniquities, they were afflicted. They were near to death. We had a number of people who shared how they almost died last year and how God intervened in the, and they weren't dead. Mark Staub shared an incredible testimony how his heart shut down. And there was no blood going to his heart while we were praying for him. I remember what happened. They said his whole systems are shutting down. We don't know what, the doctors didn't know what to do. But you know what? A year later, he's alive. He just went on a hike with no repercussions. God just totally touched him. He thanked all the prayer men that stayed with him and prayed with him and how they've been faithful and how he's just doing really great now. 1 year ago today, he was in the hospital. Remember, sweetheart, we were there. We got to pray with he and his wife and their family. But these fools, you know what? They got near to death and they said, you know what? I don't want to be a fool any longer. Unless I meet the king of fools. That's who Jesus is. He's the king of fools. And we were fooled long enough by the devil, and we cried out to the Lord, and he saved us. And he sends his word, and he heals from skin afflictions. He sends his word, and he heals from blindness. He sends his word, and cancers went away. Testimony after testimony about incurable cancers that got cured. Do you realize what we're living in? Yes. It's a good thing to give thanks to the Lord. Yes. Oh, we thank you, God. You are so good. You're gooder than we can even imagine. Oh, Lord, I pray that you'll give us a great testimony of healings. Where's someone with a testimony of healing? You want to come right here? You come up, tell everybody who you are. I'm going to left the microphone. We're supposed to stand right in front. I got instruction. I won't tap on the mic. We're ready? Okay, we got the good news signal. Tell everybody who you are and how you got healed.
My name is Cynthia. I had stage 4 non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. No chemo, no radiation. I was going to a church in Berrien, and they said I had a 99% chance of it coming back. I said I'm the 1% it won't. That was 21 years ago.
Woo! Woo! Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. It's a good thing to give thanks to the Lord for his goodness and his mercy to Cynthia. Hallelujah. Another healing. Come here, Arnold, quick. Come here, quick. Hallelujah. Here's another man prayer victim. I'll tell you, when man prayer prays, things happen. And when women crush women pray, when people in this church pray, things happen. I just found out about Patrick. That's the first time I heard the story. I didn't even recognize you. He had his stuff all over his skin. It was all over your whole body. It's all gone. Isn't that all? God is, he's gooder than you think.
He is.
Tell me, Arnold.
I'd like to see you. My name is Arnold. I'd like to see every man here at Man Prayer. It is absolutely incredible.
Yep.
2 weeks ago at 12:30, right around there noon, I was at my counter on the kitchen table reading a newspaper. My right eye, I knew what a floater was. Well, an incredibly large floater came out and swirled in my eye, and I went blind. And went to the doctor Monday morning. Surgery in the evening. Thank God for Dr. Briggs and Dr. Lee, because they reattached the retina, retinal tear, and today I can see. Today I see all of you.
Hallelujah.
It's there's still a gas bubble in my eye, continues to see, but I praise God. Yes. And knowing that I had 180 men praying for me this past couple of weeks, it is incredible.
Yes.
It's absolutely incredible that he restored my sight. Now I want to share a greater miracle. God has delivered me from anger.
Yes.
God has delivered me from pornography.
Yes. Hallelujah.
God has delivered me from anger and pornography and alcohol.
Yes.
And I am so grateful.
Yes.
So to everybody, there's hope. Thank you, Lord. I praise you, Jesus.
Woo! I'll give thanks to the Lord for his goodness and his mercy to the children of men. Woo! Oh, that men would give thanks to the Lord for his goodness, for his wonderful works to the children of men. Let them sacrifice the sacrifices of thanksgiving and declare his works with rejoicing. Those who go down to the sea in ships, who do business on great waters to see the works of the Lord and his wonders in the deep, for he commands and raises the stormy wind, which lifts up the waves of the sea. They mount up to the heavens. They go down again into the depths. Their soul melts because of trouble. They reel to and fro and stagger like a drunken man and are at their wits' end. Then they cry out to the Lord in their trouble, and he brings them out of their distresses. He calms the storm so that its waves are still, and they are glad because they are quiet. So he guides them to their desired haven. Oh, that men would give thanks to the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. We can give thanks to God not only for his mercy and his healing, because he will deliver you, but we can give thanks to the Lord for he brings you to your desired haven, and he brings you out of the storms of life. Yes, it's speaking about a storm that a mariner was in, but how many of you know that Jesus spoke to the wind and rebuked it and it calmed? Some of you are going to have testimonies of how the storm came this year and God spoke to the winds and they stopped and they ceased. He rebuked the work of the enemy and spoke peace into your heart and your situation. And it's incredible what God does, because they had declared his works through the sacrifice of thanksgiving and rejoicing. And he's going to guide you to your desired haven. He's going to bring you to your destiny. He's going to bring you into a safe harbor. He's not only going to bring you to heaven, but he's going to, on your journey to heaven, going to bring heaven to earth everywhere. Every port of de-embarkation, you're going to embark off the vessel, and you're going to release the kingdom of heaven on earth. You're going to see people saved, healed, delivered, transformed by the power of God. It's a good thing to give thanks to the Lord for his goodness and his mercy to the children of men. Who's gone through a storm? Who's gone through a storm and got through? Frank, come here. Come here, Frank. We're going to have some time at the end. I'll get one more point, and then it's freedom time. We'll get people up here. Love this man.
Hi.
Hi. Tell him who you are.
I'm Frank.
Gibson.
I'm Gibson. I'm Frank Gibson. Thanks for that. And, I will just say, for any people that have not been going here very long, I've gone through some times with cancer, et cetera, and heart attacks and open heart surgery. And you know, this church has stood with my wife and I every step of the way. You know, when something happens to you, they don't kind of push you off to the side. They embrace you. And you are actually among family here. Mm-hmm. And let me tell you, two doctors recently here in the area told me I had cancer again. And Annie and I have wrestled with that, but we really don't get wrapped around the axle about it, because you see, God healed me from cancer before. And you folks were praying. Mm-hmm. This is a praying church, by the way. Because we recognize that prayer changes things.
Right.
And you know, I went to the UW. There were people praying for me here. I went to the UW and saw the people that did my transplant. And he pulled out some old records and he looked at everything and he said, "Nope, you don't have cancer."
Woo!
How good is that?
Whoa.
Tends to make your whole day, but you know, it's not a fluke, and it's not a challenge, chance, or anything
no.
like that. These people have been praying for me, my brothers and sisters, because we are family and we
That's
love
right.
each other.
That's right. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, give thanks to the Lord for his goodness and his mercy to the children of men and for his wonderful works. Frank's a veteran. He's been an international policeman. He's a veteran. He's done all kinds of special assignments for the United States government and all kinds of things we won't talk about. He's alive today. He's also a Seattle Bible College student. He's like a second father to all the students. He loves them. He was going to go to Israel, and they were ready to cancel. He called and told Bill, we're going to cancel. And that day, the Lord spoke to me and said, I want you to call Frank and tell him he's going to Israel. I didn't know they'd called Bill and canceled the trip. I said, I felt like I'm supposed to call you. God spoke to me today when I was praying and said, Frank, you are going to Israel. He said, well, that's interesting, because we just told him we weren't going today and canceled the trip, but we wondered if we were supposed to call back and uncancel it.
And was it on the second day? He's always living with pain with all the stuff he's gone through with war and stuff and all the stuff he's done. He's a bionic man, more ways than one. And how many days were you in pain in Israel?
The first day I had pain. After that, there was no pain whatsoever. And that's the first time in 4 years.
First time in 4 years. When you cry to God, he hears your cries. You know what Frank did? He pushed Richard Burke in the wheelchair around Israel in the wheelchair on the cobblestones. God is good. We need to give thanks to the Lord. Are you the redeemed of the Lord? Then say so. Woo, I'm the redeemed of the Lord. I thank God. I praise God. Point number five, and then we're going to have lots of testimonies. Oh, give thanks for the rivers and the springs of water. Last part, where did I stop at? You can stop and start anywhere in this one. Oh, that man might give thanks to the Lord for his goodness, his wonderful works to the children of men. Let them exalt him also in the assembly of the people like we are today and praise him in the company of the elders. He turns rivers into a wilderness and the water springs into dry ground, a fruitful land into barrenness. For the wickedness of those who dwell in, he turns a wilderness into pools of water and a dry land into water springs. There he makes the hungry dwell, that they may establish a city for a dwelling place, and sow fields and plant vineyards, that they may yield a fruitful harvest. He also blesses them, and they multiply greatly. He does not let their cattle decrease. When they are diminished and brought low through oppression, affliction, and sorrow, he pours contempt on princes and causes them to wander in the wilderness where there is no way. Yet he sets on the poor on high, far from affliction, and makes their families like a flock. The righteous see it and rejoice, and all iniquity stops its mouth. Whoever is wise will observe these things, and they will understand the loving kindness of the Lord. We can give thanks to the Lord with the people and the elders, because he takes those that are wicked and causes their rivers to dry up and their water springs to become dry land. He takes the hungry and the poor, and he establishes them in cities and fields with vineyards. He blesses them. He takes their wastelands and causes water springs and rivers to flow in them. And the righteous see this, and they rejoice. He pours contempt on princes that exalt themselves and lifts the poor up amongst the out of being needy and sets them amongst the princes. He's a good God. He's way gooder than you and I can even imagine. He's going to cause rivers of living water and springs to flow out of your life so people like Patrick get healed. So people like Arnold, because you pray, he doesn't have an 8-week process where he's going to sit and recover. They don't know why. They say, we don't know why you've recovered so quickly. Well, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. We know why he recovered quickly, because we cried out to the Lord, and he heard our prayers. So has anybody had some rivers of water start to pour out of them when they were dry and thirsty? Come here, David. This is David Inglema. He's Italian. He has a really mean red sauce. He let me taste it. And meatballs. They're really good.
Hey, I moved here from the East Coast. I went through a 5-year period, a very turbulent time in my life. And a lot of loss, a lot of divorce. I was in financial ruin. I lost my father. I lost other family members. Lord moved me here to Seattle area. And I have not been without since I've been here. And one of the great things that he's done for me, too, is that I was also, like I said, in financial ruin and debt. And he released money to me I didn't even know I had. And so I'm getting like $25,000 I'm paying it all off. I have enough for tithing, too, and everything. So just want to praise God. Thank you.
Yeah. Woo! Awesome. Can you pray for people?
Yes.
Okay, David's going to pray right here. Sherry's going to come over here and pray. Is there two or three more quick testimonies? You just can't. You have to say so. You have to say so. Come on. Come on, Neil. One more. Right here. Sonnet, you come. Sorry we can't get everybody. But this is Thanksgiving. We're going to get stuffed with Thanksgiving and goodness till it comes out of us everywhere we go. You want to start, Sonnet? Go ahead. And then we'll have Sally and then Ian.
Yeah, I'm Sonnet Olson, and the storm that...
Can you move this way a little bit? Stay away from the speaker there.
The storm in our life has come in the form of infertility, and we've been trying to get pregnant for the last 3 years and failed treatments, and just through that whole process, I fell into the deepest depression I've ever experienced, and all hope. I had lost all hope. I had no faith. I had people praying for me, but it was like I couldn't even agree with them. It was just like I just came to the darkest place I've ever experienced. And through that, God started to meet me in my dreams, and he started to give me these beautiful pictures of me with babies and, you know, and so I just felt the hope started to flood me again. I started to feel the faith of God begin to flood me, and I began to believe that his promises are true and that he is going to fulfill that, and that he has given me this a strength in the last few months to just stand on his word and give him all of the fear, all of the brokenness, and that he's doing a good work, and I'm waiting to see the fulfillment of these promises, but I have hope again for the first time in a long time.
I'm like most people, I think. We live paycheck to paycheck. My work situation, the way it works out, is if my doctor doesn't work, I don't work. So she just left for 6 weeks of maternity leave, and I was, you know, biting my nails. I even said to my husband, well, maybe we should stop tithing. I think that's what God would have us do. So God woke me up in the morning and said not to be anxious for anything. So I just started back to work on Monday. We made all our bills. I had more than enough hours at other offices that needed help. So don't stop tithing. God is still faithful.
Stay here. Stay here. Thank you. Three quick short ones. One is we had some friends, young, pregnant, and the doctor was very concerned about a miscarriage. Went and prayed for them in Swedish, and a full-term baby was born several weeks ago. We almost lost my mom this year. I went to go pick her up for a doctor's appointment. Thought she was having a stroke. Turns out her sodium levels were so low that as soon as we went into the ER, they checked her and they said, we're checking her into the ICU. Her sodium levels are way below, but somehow the Lord sustained her, and now she's healthy, and we celebrated Thanksgiving together healthily. And then lastly, friends of the family had a stroke, elderly gentleman, and completely paralyzed. Thought he was going to go. Immediately started interceding, and he went home on Friday. So home to his actual, like, earthly home. He's still with us here. Sorry. Clarify. God is good.
Also, need to move this way. Also be praying for Ian. Ian's Linwood City Councilman, so you need to be praying for Ian. And he's also won a bunch of awards at work for his engineering and stuff. It's been fun to watch Ian grow up in the church and watch him. So be praying for Ian Cotton. So pray for Ian Cotton for his position as a Linwood Councilman. Also, George Hurst, Hillary's father, they used to attend here. He's also a Linwood City Councilman. So it's good to have Christians involved in politics and helping with the forming of cities. So be praying for them. Ian Cotton, write the name down. Go ahead.
Hi, I'm Elizabeth Patterson, and my knees are shaking while I'm up here. I'm really nervous. But a few years ago, God gave me a dream. I was in my house, and I was talking to my mother, and my heart was not right. And so God gave me this dream that I went into this church, and I got my heart right with God. And then when I got out of the church, there was a star that came rushing towards me out of the sky. It just came right at me. And I reached up to the heavens and the star and grabbed the star and grabbed it and put it in my pocket. And then we went home in this car that my dad was driving, and I didn't know what to do with the star because it was in my pocket. It was just flaming in my pocket. And so my mom said, "What do you do with the star?" And then I said, "I don't know. What do I do with the star?" And then I decided that I was going to take it out of my pocket and throw it out the window. And I threw it out the window, and it went up, way up into the sky, and there was borealis of light that came down. And then I praised God that the star, and then God told me that all the stars in the sky belong to me, and that and that Jesus is the Star of Bethlehem, and I praise mm-hmm. him that he is the Star of Bethlehem, and that mm-hmm. he delivered me from my heart that was not right.
Awesome.